We have already seen how Hegel influenced Marx, how Hegel thought of idealism, right? That everything originates in the mind, and human history is the evolution of the human mind, right? From sense certainty to consciousness to self-consciousness. But what influenced Marx to move away from the mind? It was this person who we are going to talk about now, Ludwig Andreas von Feuerbach. Feuerbach was part of a group called as the Young Hegelians, who were the fans of Hegel. They liked Hegel's ideas, but they pushed it forward. As we had seen, that Hegel argued that the mind evolved in three stages. First is the stage of sense certainty, where we see things or objects as things in themselves, right? That means like how an animal perceives. When a dog sees a tree, he does not see categories. He does not see the category of a tree, or if it is a guava tree or an apple tree, right? It can perceive it as it is. It's very hard for us to understand because our mind is trained to think in terms of typologies and classifications, right? So the second stage is called as the stage of consciousness, where humans developed abstract thought. That means you can think of yourself from a third person point of view, right? When you go out and you dress up, right? The dresses you wear is based on your thinking of how others will perceive you, right? You think of yourself how you will look from the eyes of the other, right? So this is the second stage. And the third stage is what is called as the stage of self-consciousness. When we realize that the objects we have created, they do not have an existence of their own, but they are human creations, like money, right? Money basically runs the world. But we tend to forget that it is not something which existed before us. It is not found in nature. We have created money. So this is the third stage of self-consciousness. So Feuerbach takes Hegel's ideas forward, and he criticizes Hegel that he did not address the true nature of alienation, right? For Feuerbach, the true alienation exists in religion, right? He says that God and religion are nothing more than projections of our human mind, right? Humans have created God, and then they worship God as if he was someone else. So Feuerbach says that material objects, like the things around you which you can see, they are not simply mental projections, as Kant or Hegel said, right? He says that reality is material. That means things that exist there are there. You know, if you stop thinking about it, it won't go away. Okay, but how we contemplate it, that is, how we understand it, that is based on our understanding of the world. You know, maybe we understand it via religion, you know, via spirituality or via science, right? It all depends how we understand the world. So Marx agreed with Feuerbach on a lot of things. Marx says that yes, Feuerbach is right. The world is material, right? When I say material, I mean matter, things that exist in physical space, right? So Marx says yes, the world is material, and religion is alienating. That means religion is something which we create, but then we look at it as something else, right? We worship it. But Marx takes Feuerbach's ideas even further, and he says that Feuerbach really did not understand the real material basis of human existence, right? Marx says that humans are not really concerned with purely material objects. Right, the stones you see around you or the pebbles, they don't concern us. What is most important is that the objective material world in which humans live is a produced one. Right? We have created this world around us. We have created these buildings, these roads, these parks, right? The vehicles, the pollution. We have created this via economic production. And this is what Marx says that Feuerbach has missed. You know, this is the essence of human nature. He says that like Hegel, you know, Feuerbach was also too focused of thinking about humans as individuals. Whereas Marx says that human nature is social. To quote him, Marx said that the essence, the human essence, is no abstraction inherent in each single individual. In its reality, it is the ensemble of social relations. What he means by this is that human nature is social. So our social relations is what makes us thrive and come together and form communities. And Marx also says that Feuerbach fell into the trap in which everyone else has fallen, the trap of philosophy. Marx argued that he just talked philosophically. You know, philosophers just talk and keep on rambling. They may have great ideas, but they do nothing. They don't change the world around us. And this was very important to Marx, change. To quote Marx, and this is a very controversial and famous quote of Marx, "The philosophers have only interpreted the world in various ways. The point, however, is to change it." This is the source of the Marxian idea of praxis. That means practical engagement with the world. Right? There is no point just keep on thinking about something. Ideas don't matter. Right? All that matters is the execution. Thanks guys for the amazing response and all your feedback on Telegram. I really appreciated it. And some of the things I have incorporated. Whereas some things I have not, like there was a lot of suggestions to start the program in Hindi, right? So I believe sociology, at least for English medium, it's better to use English because it's more or less about answer writing, right? And answer writing requires jargons. So, and also there's nowadays a lot of material in Hindi, which you can use to understand, but ultimately you have to learn how to write. So for that, I believe the lectures in English are better. We have started our mentorship program where we give lectures and there is interaction and there is a stepwise evaluation of your progress for the subject. So feel free to join at any time. We are also going to start a test series for sociology. Both of them you can subscribe in Telegram group. Thank you and see you again in our next lecture on Adam Smith and how he influenced Marx.